There's a lot of activity taking place on a recent evening at the Orso restaurant in Anchorage. Servers straighten tables, and the kitchen is busy preparing a new ingredient, Tanner crab. The chefs at Orso show off their skills by serving this new ingredient in a variety of ways. Chilled, stuffed into mushroom caps, and baked into little cheesy triangles with spinach. Tanner crab will be included in the specials for the next few days, so tonight's crowd gets to test the new delicacies. Upstairs, Teresa Peterson is setting up photos of fishermen in Kodiak. Peterson serves as outreach coordinator for the Kodiak branch of the Alaska Marine Conservation Council, but she's also an active fisherwoman and longtime resident of Kodiak. She says tonight's event is a celebration for the end of the Tanner crab season, which is only 1 week long. But it's also a handy way to tell people about the Catch of the Season program.
It's been a nice opportunity to connect the fishermen from the area with people from Anchorage.
Modeled after community-supported agricultural programs like Full Circle Farm, potential customers can purchase Tanner crab directly from the fishermen in Kodiak in either 10 or 50-pound boxes. Peterson says this also ties into the Working Waterfronts program, which encourages more sustainable fishing methods and connects fishermen directly to potential customers. And Peterson is quick to point out that Tanner crab is also pretty tasty.
I find the taste to be a little bit sweeter than other bear dye crab and snow crab. And in particular, the crab around Kodiak are just a little bit larger, so you get a little bit more bang for your buck when you're cracking the crab.
Peterson says the goal is to provide an increased market opportunity for the fishermen and the Kodiak Island economy, as well as to get the word out to the restaurants and potential customers of just what people in Kodiak do.
Hopefully there'll be an increased demand from consumers on the mainland to support their local fishermen by buying our local seafood.
Charlie Peterson, Teresa's son, was raised working on his family's fishing boat. He says the way the Tanner crab season is regulated allows the Department of Fish and Game to keep the population from being overfished. Each of the 180 license holders are limited to only 20 crab pots, so smaller boats have even competition with larger boats.
They only fish from 8 till 6 in the or 6 in the evening, so it's like daylight hours, and every boat is only allowed 20 pots, so it's real even.
Advertising for the Catch of the Season program has been limited to online efforts through email and social media, but word of mouth has been the most effective method. Packages of Tanner crab were sold to around 70 individual customers, but a few restaurants decided to buy in this year, too. In addition to the Orso, both the Marx Brothers Cafe and Crush Wine Bistro and the Mill Bay Coffee in Kodiak served Tanner crab this year. Peterson says the Catch of the Season program is very interested in expanding to include jig caught rockfish and Pacific cod.
We're hoping to bring more premium quality products that are being handled with the best handling practices on board and caught by community-based small boat fishermen, and helping expand some of those markets for our community-based fishermen. So keep your eye out for some cod and rockfish down the line.
Between individual customers and the wholesale purchases from restaurants, the Catch of the Season program was able to sell just over 1,900 pounds of Tanner crab. In Anchorage, this is Heather Aronno.